Well, I think it's a terrific story about some wonderful people. It's pretty much that simple.
The humor is incredible in this film.
Look, I said I want my money back.
Made her mad, by God, didn't he?
The first thing about that this script has going for it is that before it was ever a script, it was great literature. The writing is just so strong that this, it can't fail.
I hadn't read the book before I read the screenplay, but once I started to read the book, it was so helpful to me. It gave me a world of, the whole era was right there in the style of writing, in the details of his description, and the interior monologue of the characters. You'd go into each character as much as any other character, so you'd really get different points of view of that time and how hard it really was to survive then, and the small things that were the joys of life. Taking a tub, pumping it out of the earth, you know, that was, or dipping it over into the Rio Grande. I thought the Rio Grande was this huge river because I thought of it like the Grand Canyon. The Rio Grande, I pictured this huge thing. It's this little stream across from where we had the Lonesome Dove set, the town, the Dust Bowl.
This television series, I should say, I call them all movies, but it's a miniseries, is rather well made and very beautiful. It's exciting and adventurous and funny and heartbreaking. Those are all excellent ingredients for improving an audience's time.
Let's go, Gus. We got some horse thieves tracked down.
I got them just when I was getting comfortable.
You could make a movie about almost any one of the 10 or 12 principal characters in this movie and sit there for 2 hours and be fascinated. Dish is the guy on the cattle drive who's sort of the top hand, and he's in charge of the cows and all the men when Call, Tommy Lee Jones, or Gus, Robert Duvall aren't around. And the main conflict for Dish is that while he's a man's man and he's a leader around the guys, he's so hopelessly in love with this girl, Lorena, who's played by Diane Lane, that he becomes incapable of doing anything, even talking really, when she's even mentioned. So it's an interesting contrast. And he's sort of, I guess, you know, he represents sort of like the great contrast in men in the old West, that they were these men's men, but they were painfully shy, you know.
What is it about Woodrow Call? He's been a law enforcement officer most of his life, and to a certain extent always will be. He's a leader of men. Uncomfortable in towns, uncomfortable in the company of ladies, and believes in the great struggle between good and evil, and he's on the side of good. Wants the world to be good, has an idea of what a fine place the world could be if people would just act right. Not everybody does, and those are the ones that he wants to talk to.
I don't reckon you would have killed me.
It don't matter much now, though. Does it?
You Rangers! I expect I'll kill a passel of you yet.
I doubt it. Not unless you can sprout wings and fly through the hangman's noose.
Portraying Lorena was nice because it wasn't just your stereotypical roles that you've seen in more old-fashioned westerns. You know, the style of filming was almost limited as much as the story they were telling, you know, is very, Annie, get your gun. I mean, it was great, but it was also very Oklahoma, like Broadway. And this is much more gritty. I'll never forget the scenes we did with Blue Duck, where I'm in the dirt for a day with the scorpions and spiders and ants crawling in my skirt. It was very adventurous. I said, that's it. I've done everything in one day. There's nothing left that can crawl up my skirt. There's no snakes here. It's too dry. But it was heavy. I was all bruised.
Clara Allen is Gus's longtime love. Gus is played by Robert Duvall. She lives near Ogallala on the way to Montana. She's a rancher's wife. Her husband is sick. He's been kicked in the head by a horse. She's got two daughters, and she's his sort of ideal. and had been, they'd been childhood sweethearts, so he comes back to Ogallala to find her, to see her. Very strong, very independent. She's seen a lot of trouble in her time. She's lost three boys, and she's a very original character, wonderful character, extremely passionate, very honest, very straightforward, very judgmental. I liked her a lot.
First of all, I mean, what's so obvious about him is that he's a great scout and tracker. As T.I. says, he can read tracks better than some people can read newspapers. He has been with this bunch for 20 years and is part of this family in a way. And it's his only family in a sense.
I'm Dietz. Captain sent me ahead to scout a good place across the herd. Mr. Jake napping, huh?
He's cut a mesquite thorn in his hand. It's made him sick.
Better take a look.
A good person, you know, it's just saying. Saying he's a good person, a good, honest person. Emotional, caring person. He, in some ways, plays the role of being the surrogate father for Newt, as several of them do at different points in time. I think that role is interchangeable among these men. And a real, honest, solid person.
So long, girls. Don't let the Indians get you while we're gone.
You always got a joke, don't you, Gus?
Who's joking?
I wanted to work with Duval, and that was a really wonderful experience for me to work with him. Well, he has a sense of humor about the business in general and his part in it, and I appreciate that a lot because so many people don't. And he can crack you up if you need it, and he likes to get stuff out of you. And I think earlier in my career that would have put me off, to have an actor do that with me. But he did, and I really appreciated it.
I hope you can swim. I can't swim. Back the boat. About 30 seconds. Hold on. Hold on. The whole damn boat. Hello. He's very deep in. I'm so good here. Man, this water's so cold. I believe it shriveled my pie.
He's an extraordinary actor, and I don't think I've ever worked with anyone who is so giving to other actors. And he thinks for you all the time. He's happiest when he's giving, and he's remarkable to work with. It was such a pleasure to work with him. He's a fantastic actor.
With your permission, Bob. I'd like a kiss. Come on. Now stop it. I swear you beat any woman I ever saw for taking the starch out of a man.
He's a rather quick actor. And a very good one. You don't have to waste a lot of time talking when you're working with an actor of that quality.
That'll be a dollar.
Now, besides the whiskey, I think we'll require a little respect.
There were a lot of Westerns made in the 40s and 30s that wound up being people's favorite movies. I think the appeal of the so-called Western movie is really the appeal of the men who made them.
It's epic. It's about people. It's about love. It's about life. It's about violence. It's about men and women. It's about overcoming fear. It's about bravery, it's about adventure. It's classic Western, real classic Western.
There's something about the Western, there's something about its manner in which it it explores, I guess, a real basic fundamental of this country, you know, the exploration, the man, the individual.
I had done a Western previous to this one. It was my second movie. It was a Western. It's called Catalani and Little Britches with Burt Lancaster, Rod Steiger. I was 14 then. I learned a lot on screen, I think, making that Western. But it wasn't such a far reach mentally for me to go back into what that time was like and how little they had to work with and how much they made with the little they had.
Women were mainly an adjunct to the romantic cowboy of early Westerns. They wore corsets or they hung out in the saloons in black stockings and a rose in their hair. I think that this is a big jump from that, certainly. The women are very much realized in the script. McMurtry's done a tremendous amount for the woman in Westerns by mere fact that he's given all of us very defined characters and entered into these characters as fully as he's entered into the men's.
Very interesting how he treats the issue of women in this book, which is a bit differently treated than most times that I've seen in Westerns, you know. Even women who are barroom women in this book and who have portrayed those roles in previous Westerns do not have the kind of realism. This seems to be such a real depiction of relationships, in a sense.
They couldn't go out and do the things that the men were doing. They weren't allowed, they weren't expected to, they weren't trained to, they weren't accepted, and they were forced into being more feminine than today's women because the door wasn't open to be anything else. And I don't think they necessarily knew what they were missing. They didn't resent anything, and they weren't necessarily happy about it either. One way or the other, they were just limited in terms of what their options were.
I've already been to San Antonio. I don't want to go back.
Ain't you the hard one to please?
I know what I ain't. I just want to go to San Francisco. Like you promised me. Well, that'd please me just fine.
A lot of the women in these little towns way out in the far west had no other way to survive than prostitution. They were, you know, depicted as being sort of charming, heart of gold girls who really didn't do much except bring a glass of whiskey to you in the saloon. And that was about all the censors would allow. We can get a little bit closer to the truth nowadays. We're more sophisticated.